This is an audio processing software called Audacity. When the computer records sound through the microphone, the software shows a visual representation of the recording, and it looks like this. Most of you have seen this kind of stuff before, but not many understand what it actually represents. I mean, you can sort of see that loud sounds produce fat sausages and quiet sounds produce thin sausages. When you zoom it in, you can see it is actually not really a lumpy snake, but actually a waveform. It represents the changes of something during time. Time goes from left to right, and something is being represented by the height of the line that varies many, many times in a second. Let's make an experiment. I have here a loudspeaker that is connected into this computer. What happens if I edit the waveform so that it goes constantly from up to down and up again? What's the diaphragm of the speaker? It goes up and down just like the curve on the screen. Now watch what happens if I increase the frequency by making the waveform change more rapidly with respect to time. First, 20 Hz. Then 40 Hz. Then 100 Hz. 400. 2000. It becomes impossible to discern the motion of the diaphragm by the naked eye because it is vibrating so fast, but the changes are sensed very, very clearly by the ear. This is because the diaphragm of the speaker pushes air in front of it, and these changes in air pressure are sensed by your ear. Some of you maybe noticed the noise didn't exactly sound like pure sine wave. That's because I actually destroyed the speaker by driving too high voltage to it when I attempted to visualize the infrasound. Don't do this at home. And that's how the speaker produces sound. Now let's see how to do this in software. SDL is a library that is commonly used to add input video and audio processing into programs. There are many libraries that can do the same. In most of them, the principles are similar. I'm not going to argue superiority of any of them. This is just what I use to get things done. This is the documentation page describing SDL audio. A couple of important functions are highlighted. This example program will be a simple beeper that alternates between different tones like a Lego police car. First, we initialize the audio by configuring the standard parameters, the audio sampling rate, that is how many times in a second we want to be able to change the speaker diaphragm position, the audio format, which is just how accurately we want to control the diaphragm, and the number of audio channels to have. The audio system requires a steady stream of audio data in order to produce sound. In SDL and many other libraries, the system allows you to define a function from your own code that the library will call whenever it needs more audio data. This is called a callback. The callback function is supposed to write the list of speaker diaphragm positions into an array supplied by the library. These positions are consumed by the rate you've specified. Here, for example, they are consumed at a rate of 96,000 samples per second, assuming the library didn't change the rate when the device was opened. This example code just generates a square wave, that is, it alternates between minus 0.5 and plus 0.5, so that it goes the full cycle 440 times per second, or whichever frequency is specified in the pitch variable. It is not the most efficient solution and not the best sounding one, but simple enough that it gets the job done. And this is how it sounds. Because computers used to be very slow and the storage space used to be very expensive, in the past there were signal generator chips that could generate these kind of signals by just feeding the right kind of electrical inputs to them. Some of those chips were very sophisticated and capable of quite impressive audio. But of course, you don't need to be limited to simple beeps. Your callback function can do anything, including generate music or replay speech samples.
Who can find a virtuous woman, for her price is far above rubies. The heart of her husband doth safely trust in her.
Stay tuned when we launch this little snippet of code into complex action in a future video that requires still more theoretical background. Have a nice day. Take care and be well.